Hello, I am Flash Isaac,
and today
I shall be taking you through sentence completion. Completion simply means to finish or to complete. Therefore, sentence completion simply means completing of sentences, which implies that you will be given incomplete sentences and asked to complete them. Now, the way you complete a sentence depends on the nature of the sentence and also depends on what the sentence requires. For that, we shall go straight into questions and answers under sentence completion, so that for every question you see, you know what is expected of you. In this class, I shall be making use of the Flash Learners applications. Let us begin. The first question here says, both questions are alternative. You answer -1, -the other. Both questions are alternative. What does it mean for questions to be alternative? Both simply means we have two questions. Question A and question B. The question being alternative simply means you can answer this one and leave this one, or leave this one and answer this one. So you can answer either this or that is what it means. If you are given two things and you are asked to choose at least one of them, you choose one or the other. Now, if you are given two options and you don't need to choose any of them, then you say neither this nor that. So either goes with or, neither goes with no, concord, agreement. Now, both questions are alternative. You answer -1, -the other. So you either answer one or you answer the other. Option D is the correct option. Option A is wrong because we are told to answer at least one. So neither will not come in. Neither is when you don't need to answer any one out of the two. Then both. If you have to answer both, then it won't be alternative. And you answer both one and the other does not make sense. Look at option C. Neither will only go with no, while either will go with or. This guy and this guy, they don't work together. And either and no, they don't work together as well. So we've gotten our answer. Option D. The pastor addressed his dash in a sonorous voice. The pastor. A. Audience. B. Masses. C. Spectator. And D. Congregation. This falls under register words associated with a particular subject. Now, talking about pastor, who are the persons pastors address? They are simply the members of their church. And members of the church are referred to as congregation. Not spectator. Spectator are those who watch sports match. Not masses. For politicians, if they're addressing their people, you say, okay, the governor is addressing the masses. Then audience for drama, for shows. Therefore, congregation is correct. The pastor addressed his congregation in a sonorous voice. So option D is the correct option. The commissioner for education with his secretary dash expected yesterday. The answer is was expected yesterday. We are not concerned about the secretary or any other thing. What we are concerned with is the commissioner for education. So the verb should agree with the commissioner for education. When you see stuff like as, well as, together with, or with, as seen in this question, the noun that determines the choice of verb to be used is the first one. So if I say John, as well as his father, mother, grandchildren, great-grandchildren, uncles, aunties, any other thing, the verb will simply follow John is here. Simple. So if I say Luke, as well as all the students in the school is here. So This is what will determine the choice of verb, not any other thing. This applies to together with and with. John, together with his children, is here. Now, what if I say the students as well as John, or the students together with John? The verb will simply be, if you follow this, it won't be singular verb, it will be plural verb. So the verb that agrees with the students will be used. So the students together with John were here. I hope you understand that. In this case, the commissioner for education with his secretary was here. And the next question, the lecturer arrived exactly dash time to give the talk. Looking at these options, the ones that will even make sense or qualify to be the answer are A, on, and D, in. Meaning, we are talking about on time and in time. When you come on time, it means you came at the exact time or at the expected time. If the party is or the meeting is 8 a.m., if you are there exactly 8 a.m. or you are expected to come 2 minutes earlier or 2 minutes after the time you are expected, then you arrived on time. But in time simply means you arrived before time, before you were expected, before the time. That is the difference between in time and on time. Now, this says arrived exactly. So it means as planned. So he arrived on time. A is the correct option. And the next question. I have the news dash the radio. The correct answer is I have the news on the radio. On the radio. Then, isn't it high time we dash dash? Isn't it high time we dash? Anytime you see it is high time or it is time, the verb that follows should be in past tense. So when you see it is high time or it is time, the verb must be in past tense. If you say it is high time we go home, wrong. It is high time we went home, correct. Applying this rule, isn't it high time we started eating is correct. So that is the correct option. After much debate on the controversial issue, the meeting was dash dash till the next morning, which simply means the meeting was postponed till the next morning. But this question still obeys register, like I said. When it comes to meeting, the word associated with postponed is adjourned. You don't say meeting postponed. You say that the meeting has been adjourned. The meeting is to be continued. So we won't say postponed. We simply say adjourned because it relates to meeting, and adjourned is the most appropriate word to use. Then this is one of the three guests. Of the three guests, Yetunde is the dash. A, tallest. B, taller. C, most tall, and D, tall. Out of the three, positive, comparative, and superlative. If you are comparing two things, if this is good, this is simply better, and this is best. If this is bad, this is simply worse, and this is simply worst. So, if you are comparing two things, the highest form you can get is the comparative form, which is worse, better. That is all. Then when you are comparing up to three, then you get to best, worst, and so on. Beautiful, more beautiful, most beautiful. Where most beautiful is for three comparison or more, and more beautiful is for two. Now, we are comparing three guests, and we are comparing them based on height, which means this one is tall, this one is taller, this one is the tallest. So, of the three girls, Yetunde is the tallest, correct. Of the two girls, Yetunde is taller, correct. Yetunde is tall, good, because you are not comparing. You don't say more better. Wrong. You simply say better, because more better, you are doing double comparison. Better simply means this is more than this. So why say more better? It means you are better, better. That is double comparison. Good. The next one. The two girls have not been speaking dash since their quarrel. Now, since we are talking about two girls, they have not been speaking to each other. When they are two, you use each other. When they are more than two, you use one another. So, each other is correct. The two girls have not been speaking to each other since their quarrel. And the next question says, after a while, we noticed that the unconscious accident victim was coming dash dash. A, coming around. B, coming on. C, coming off. And D, coming through. When someone is unconscious, with time, maybe you notice the person starts reviving. So you notice that this person is coming through. So coming through is correct. To come, it means to regain strength or to regain consciousness. That is the most appropriate answer. The workers' strike was dash as a result of the director's intervention. A, called back. B, called in. C, called off. And D, called off. If you are a student, you should not be new to the word strike. You hear something like, they've called off the strike. This means they've brought the strike to an end. This means you can resume. So there can be strike in other sectors, but to call off strike simply means to put a strike to an end, to resume work. So called off is the most appropriate. Not dash person will do that. A, matured. B, maturing. C, mature. And D, matures. The correct thing is mature. No mature person will do that. You may be arguing, why mature? Why not matured? Look at it. In this case, mature is acting as an adjective. Why? It is telling us about now. So you use M-A-T-U-R. If mature is acting as a verb, you use matured. If I say, he has now matured, therefore, that he has now matured is acting as a verb. In that usage, you can use D. He renders dash assistance to the community. A, variable. B, invaluable. C, intrusive. And D, valued. Now, out of all this, variable is wrong, intrusive is wrong. So we are not thinking out of invaluable and valued, which best completes the sentence. The correct thing is invaluable. Invaluable means very, very valuable, like priceless, very, very important. So he rendered an invaluable assistance to the community. Invaluable does not mean useless or unimportant. It means very important service. I could not attend the meeting, so I asked my sister to stand dash for me. Stand in is correct. In, which means to represent. I could not attend the meeting, so I asked my sister to stand in for me. And stand that means to be outstanding, unique. You won't tell your dad, dash dash you. This is under question tag. And for question tag, positive question tag, we take negative answers. Negative, we take positive question tag. Positive statement, we take negative question tag. Negative statement, we take positive question tag. Look at what I mean. If I say, you don't mean it, what is the opposite of this? Is do. So, you don't mean it to you. You did not do it, did you? So, didn't. We go with, did you? Now look at something. You did it. You did it. Positive. The question tag that will follow is negative. Didn't you? Didn't you? So in this case, you won't tell the daddy. Won't. Negative. The question tag should be, will you? Positive. So A is correct. You won't tell daddy.
with you? The reason why he was not offered admission was that his result could not be found. The reason why should always be followed by not because. Because is the same thing as reason. So the reason why is that. The reason should be followed by that. The reason is that. Thou shalt not say that the reason why is because. No, it does not make sense. So the reason is that. In fact, in most cases, I don't think you should say the reason why. Simply say the reason is that, or why I did not do it is that. Because the reason why, because they are somehow similar. And the next one, it is high time we dash seeing her. Like I explained earlier, it is high time should be followed by past tense. So it is high time we stopped is correct. Since the fight, Joy and Gift have refused to talk to each other. Like I said, two persons, each other, best complete the sentence. Dash went to the stadium to watch a football match. Amadi and I went to the football stadium to watch the match. The public library has stopped Dash books to readers. They have stopped lending books to readers. Lending is the best option in the sense that you go to the library to borrow books. The library, on the other hand, lends you the book. So they lend, you borrow. The library has stopped lending books to readers. That is correct. He was both a writer and a politician, but was better dash a singer, but was better as a singer, not as if a singer or like a singer. Had Aisha realized what marriage entails, she would not have rushed into it. That is the correct option. And it makes a lot of sense. She would not have rushed into it. This is a conditional statement. It has already happened. Had Aisha realized what marriage entails, it simply means she did not realize what marriage entailed. So in the past, she did not realize. So she jumped into marriage. A lot of persons, you don't know what certain things entail, you just jump. Don't know what relationship entails, you jump into relationship because you want to jump into it. Lehman doesn't like walking in the dark. Question tag, doesn't, which means it is negative. The answer will be positive, does. So option B is correct, does she? Limo doesn't like wandering in the dark. Does she like wandering? Now it can be this way. If I say, does Limo like wandering in the dark? You will say, Limo does not like wandering in the dark. So it's like question and answer. Either the teacher or the student dash dash to blame. So either or, it simply means one of them. And when you're talking about one, you simply use is, which implies that either the teacher or the student is to blame. The police described the boy as being dash hand, as being out of hand, which means this boy is very stubborn. Like, this one has passed, be careful. People say it now. You see that, say, ah, John has gone out of hand. Ah, this one don't go far. So you've gone out of hand. So the police described the boy as out of hand is correct. And here is Mr. Odumosu, who teaches English pronunciation in our school. This is to test your spelling. So you have to complete the sentence with the best spelling. And to spell pronunciation is simply pronunciation. That is the correct spelling for pronunciation, as you can see in option C. And here I say, I am not surprised that Zali had a road accident. He was always too fast. He was, question tag, wasn't he? Was, wasn't he? Option B is correct. The plan for the party, dash dash, due to incorporation. Incorporation means introducing new corporation, new plan. So fell through, it means it did not happen. That is the meaning of fell through, it failed to happen. So the plan for the party failed to happen due to incorporation. The dash robber showed no mercy during the attack. Loquacious, meaning he's talking too much. Senseless means it doesn't have sense. Ruthless means wicked. Benevolent means nice, kind. So for him not to show mercy, it simply means he is useless. So he is ruthless. So
The ruthless robber showed no mercy during the attack. Ruthless means cruel, pitiless, no compassion, no joy, zero joy, no cap. Of course, we all saw the culprit dash dash hit the man. We all saw the culprit approach and hit the man. Approach is correct. Look at something. There are some certain statements that may not make sense to you, but they actually make sense. If I say, I saw him stealing the meat and I saw him steal the meat, which is correct, it is still, I saw him steal the meat, because these are fast action. It happened. It does not take years to happen. It did not take centuries to happen. It just happened. If I say, I saw him cross the road and I saw him crossing the road, which is correct, it is, I saw him cross the road. It happened. You've crossed. In this case, you saw the culprit hit the man. So, bah, that is it. It did not take time or years for the hitting, which is approach. He just approached and hit the man. He went. So, ladies and gentlemen, that will be all for today. I am Flash Isaac, and don't forget to subscribe to this channel for more amazing videos. Have a wonderful day.